Hello guys, welcome to my channel HUI Tutorials. In this video, we will discuss about XPath and its types. So basically, what is meant by XPath? XPath is a programming language that is designed for querying the XML nodes. Okay, or you can say it is designed for finding the controls in the HTML document. So this XPath is basically designed for XML documents, but it can also be used for other document object models. Like HTML is having some document object model, right? So whatever is having this document object model, in those documents, you can utilize this XPath. Okay. So this XPath is defined by the World Wide Web Consortium. It is an international organization that is maintaining the web standards. Okay. So how many types of XPath are there? We have two types of XPath. One is absolute XPath and next one is relative XPath. So in the absolute XPath, the XPath starts from the root element and it will always start with single slash. Single slash means the current node. Okay. So it will start from the root element and it will use single slash in the starting. So one of the disadvantage of this absolute XPath is it follows the structure. So like inside HTML, if you have a body, you need to mention that the body is there. Then after the body, if you have a div, inside div, if the input tag is there, you need to clearly mention the path to that target element. Okay. So tomorrow, if the web page changes, if there is any new element added in the order, like any new div or something new input tag, then your XPath may get failed. So let me show you how it looks like. So here I have one website that is W3 Schools. Okay. So here we have some menu control, right? Tutorials, references, examples, exercises. So I wanted to click on this exercises. Okay. So let me just inspect this. So this is the element. So now I need to write the XPath, the absolute XPath for this element. Okay. So how you can write from the root element, you need to come first HTML, then body. Inside body, you have this div. This div, if you want to refer, you need to count the index. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth div. Okay. Then inside that, you need to find out. Okay. Let's write the XPath, absolute XPath here. HTML. Then inside body. Div of 4. So first, let's see what this is highlighting. So we want this one. Okay. So I think the index starts from the 1. So div of 5 inside that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. My element is fifth one. So A of 5. So now you can see this element is highlighted. Okay. So imagine tomorrow if there is another menu control added between examples and exercises. So what happens? This A index will be increasing, right? Because if you see here, this A are the menu controls. So tomorrow, if something added here, then obviously my A position will be at sixth position and my XPath is pointing to the fifth position. So my XPath will get failed. Or tomorrow, if this div tag itself is moved from fifth position to sixth position, then in that case also my XPath will get failed. So if there is any change in the structure of the document, then XPath will be failed. Okay. So to avoid that, we better choose the relative XPath, okay, which does not follow structure manner. Okay. So here the XPath is starting with the root element. So in the relative XPath, the XPath will not start from the root element. It starts from any point in the document based on the search criteria. Okay. So this relative XPath uses double slash. So for writing relative XPath, you need to use double slash first. You can see this is the example for basic relative XPath. So let me write the XPath for this one, exercises, in a relative manner. Okay. So this is like absolute XPath. So let me just paste it here. And now I'm going to write the XPath for this in a relative manner. So if you see, this A has ID. Okay. So let me copy the ID. Double slash your tag name A and open the braces at the rate, the attribute that is ID and the attribute value. Okay. So you can see it says 1 of 1. That means this XPath is fetching us unique element, that is this one. So tomorrow, if there is a new element added in the menu also, my XPath will not fail until and unless this ID is changing. Okay. So because this XPath is not in the structured order, it is directly targeting to the element based on the element attribute value, right? So that is the reason it is always advisable to use the relative XPath. So the relative XPath basic structure will look like this. Okay. Double slash, then tag name. So the tag name can be anything like input, anchor tag, or div tag, table, or anything. Okay. Then @ attribute equal the attribute value. So for example, if this is a simple HTML element, then you write the XPath in this manner. Like here, the tag is this one, input. So double slash input. Then all these things are called attributes, and this red one is called attribute values. Okay. So then @, if you want to find out the element using class, @ class equal input text. So that is how we need to write the relative XPath. So let me just execute these things and show you how it works. So both the things are correct only. Okay. So when you click on this, the small menu will open. Okay, the submenu. So let me just create a class file here. I'll name it as XPath part 1. So here I need the code for launching the browser also, right? So let me just copy that from other class. I'll paste it here, and my URL is this one. So I need to navigate to this URL. So before that, I will just maximize the window. So now let me inspect the same element first with absolute XPath, then with this relative XPath. By the locator is XPath. So first let me take the XPath, this absolute one. .click. So let me give some thread.sleep for 2 seconds. So after that, I will quit the browser. Okay, so let me execute this and we'll see it is clicking on that or not. So the browser window is opened. It is navigating to the URL. See, it clicked on the exercises menu, right? So that is how we use absolute XPath. The way we write this inside Selenium is same. It does not differ, okay? If you are using absolute XPath or if you are using relative XPath, the syntax is same. It doesn't change. So now let me use the relative XPath. So this is the relative XPath. I'll use this and I'll execute the script. The browser window is opened. Navigated to the URL, you can see. By using relative XPath also, it clicked on the exercises menu. So this is how we use the XPath, guys. So in the next video, we will discuss about what are the functions available in the XPath and how we can use them. Okay. So now we have seen if we have ID, we have directly used this ID attribute and created one relative XPath. So in the next video, we will see if there is no attribute available. Okay. So let's say this ID class name is also not available. In that case, how we are going to target the element, how we are going to find out the element, that we will see in the next video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.
I hope you enjoyed this session. If you like this video, please hit the like button and also share it with your friends. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.